Hope. For us living in North America, hope is a vague desire we take for granted. We hope our favorite pizza is on the buffet. We hope our team wins a basketball game Friday night. We hope we have a comfortable mattress when we stay in a motel. Hope is a matter of personal convenience in our daily activities. But in the lives of the rural farmers in the Central American country of Nicaragua, hope is the strength for survival from day to day, to provide a home, food, and healthy living conditions for their families. Unfortunately, that hope has been broken by the poverty that these farmers and their families have been born into and remain within because of their no way out mentality. What these Nicaraguans need is a new hope, a revived hope, a hope that gives a reason to believe in a brighter future. Now is the time for North Americans to relearn what real hope is. It is time for us to recognize the hope only God gives. It is time to share God's hope by using the resources He's blessed us with to revive the hope the Nicaraguan farmers and their families so desperately need. This revival of hope is the basis for the Farmer to Farmer program. Because of the overwhelming poverty in Nicaragua, it is basically impossible for poor farmers to own their own land. Instead, they must rent land from the wealthy landowners. Without that pride of ownership, Nicaraguans have lost hope. And so Farmer to Farmer came into being. It began in the fall of 2001 with the idea of creating land for landless farmers. The premise of the program was to give farmers a way to purchase their own land. With the help of our missionaries in Nicaragua, a Christian Nicaraguan organization looked into purchasing a 90-acre parcel of land. Farmers would be able to purchase a 4 to 5 acre plot of this land. They would make payments on their land with the payments going into a revolving fund, eventually allowing more land to be purchased to help more farmers get started. In the process, families would be able to not only own their own land, but also, through the work of our missionaries and Nicaraguan Christian organizations, be educated in improved farming methods and community development. Hope could be reignited into the Nicaraguan culture, one farming family at a time. Farmer to Farmer Iowa became involved in the project in the spring of 2002. We made a commitment to raise $90,000 in 3 years to be designated specifically for the land purchases. We sent a team down to Nicaragua to meet the farmers and to see the land that had been purchased with the money raised in the United States. There were 14 participating families in the community where the project began. What the team saw when they went down were 14 families, extremely proud that they were able to make payments toward the ownership of their land. The team took part in a dedication service, committing the land and those working on it to God's hand. The program was still small, but the spark of hope had been lit. Since then, Farmer to Farmer has flourished. God has been at work, blessing the land, the farmers, and all those involved in the program. There are now 54 families in the program, with 4 land purchases in 2 different communities in Nicaragua. Farmer to Farmer Iowa has far exceeded the $90,000 goal. The revolving fund is starting to be used, showing that the farmers are indeed working hard to pay off their loans. When the team went for the third time to visit the farmers in Nicaragua in the winter of 2005, the vision of a new hope was very evident. Although the different communities are progressing at various levels, all the farmers are moving towards land ownership and community development. Crops are being planted and harvested. Families are building homes on their land. They are planting small gardens to supply their daily food. Sanitary latrines are being built, and farmers are implementing their new knowledge of improved farming methods, soil conservation, and non-traditional crops. Communities are strong and growing stronger, built on the hope of a better future and trust in our Almighty Heavenly Father. Farmer to Farmer has grown to include 3 basic components: the Land for Landless Farmers program, which was the original project, a silo grain storage program, and a non-traditional crops and marketing plan. All of these components are working towards improving the farmers' use of their land, crops, and money. Farmer to Farmer continues to strongly support the Nicaraguan farmers. After 3 years of working with many of the same people, we are building close relationships with them that have broken down language and cultural barriers. We pray for and mentor the farmers as we learn from one another. We pray for and encourage our missionaries working as our bridge in Nicaragua. Farmer to Farmer has also expanded its involvement beyond the $90,000 originally pledged. We continue to raise money for the program to be used to improve the farmers' lives through training and development. We are helping to fund well and irrigation projects to increase crop yields. We are supporting the Nicaraguan organizations so they can employ Nicaraguan agronomists who spend time with the farmers and educate them. And we are considering a loan for 8 coffee farmers so they can eliminate the middleman in the roasting and processing of the coffee beans. In all our monetary donations, it is very clear to the farmers that this money is not a free gift. In order to promote ownership and self-sufficiency, our money goes to the local Nicaraguan organizations so that they can oversee the spending. Farmers know that any money they receive is a loan and it must be repaid. Our connection with the Nicaraguans came full circle when 4 of the Nicaraguan leaders in the project came to Iowa to visit and see our side of the work being done. We introduced them to our method of agriculture through various farm tours and visits to local ag-related businesses. One of the highlights of their visit was a tour of the heritage village in Sioux Center. They were able to see how our ancestors started many years ago and compare that to where we are today. Being able to see the progression over the years gave them hope to continue their work in farming in Nicaragua, trusting that God will also bless them and help their farming economy develop. They also took part in our harvest celebration as we dedicated the grain and monies that have been donated to the program since its beginning 3 years ago. And together we harvested a field, the crop completely donated to the Farmer to Farmer program. Our purpose was not to show them how underdeveloped their country is. We've learned from each other that how we farm may not be appropriate for how they farm. Our purpose was to learn from each other and deepen our connection in the Farmer to Farmer program across language and culture through God's love. God has blessed this project beyond anyone's expectations. His power is only limited by our finite plans. When we trust in His love and grace, He will do more than all we ask or imagine. God has reestablished hope in both our lives and in the Nicaraguan families and organizations. He is teaching all of us daily that hope comes only from Him in His power and timing. We see hope burning like wildfire, and we believe in a new future for the Nicaraguans and a new and living definition of hope for us all. Without hope, there is no creativity. Without creativity, there is no thinking. Without thinking, there is no development. And without development, there is no future.